What if password autofill won't work? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I'm finally using a password vault. The problem? It won't fill in on some sites, so I have to remember those passwords anyway. What's the point? To be clear, you do not need to remember those passwords. There are other ways to get those passwords from your vault into the password field, and I'll cover those. However, when this happens, it's very important that you stop and make sure you're actually going to the site you think you are. This is one of the best ways that password managers actually help you be more secure. Because if you get tricked by a phishing attempt, the password manager may very well notice before you do. For example, let's say you get email. A classic example is something from PayPal that says, hey, there's something to do with your account. Click on this link to fix it. You click on the link, and yeah, it looks like the PayPal sign-on page. But it's the URL in the address bar that actually triggers your password manager. And if that URL is not actually PayPal, the password manager won't fill anything in, because that's what it uses to determine what site you're on. So if you're on some phisher's fake site, you know, paypal.com.somerandomservice.com.randomisp.com, I mean, basically a very long, complicated URL. If you don't notice that it is not, in fact, paypal.com, your password manager will. And the sign that something might be amiss is that the password manager isn't filling in your credentials, or not even suggesting credentials. So, number one, when this happens, pay attention. Double check that you're actually at the site you think you are. So, what if you are? Well, here's what's weird about password fields. There is not a standard. There are many common approaches to generating password fields or sign-in fields, but in reality, websites can do different things all the time, and they do. That means that your password manager might not be able to figure out what it is that needs to be filled in on this specific site. Most of the time it can, and it does. But sometimes sites are constructed in such a way that your password manager just can't figure it out. Sometimes it's a side effect of design. Sometimes it's intentional. I would call it misguided intentional, because it's usually done because the designers think that the techniques used by password managers are less secure than forcing you to type something in. Unfortunately, I don't agree with that. Using a password manager is still safer than all of the alternatives, but that's what happens. So let's take a look at what this might look like in practice. So over here, I'm in askleo.com. I'm taking a look at the site, and let's say I want to log in. I'll go to my account page, and down here is the login field. Now you'll notice nothing's been filled in. If I click in it, all of a sudden, I get my 1Password icon, and it makes a suggestion. That implies that indeed this is askleo.com, and you can double check that in the address bar, and these are my credentials from a previous visit. If I click on it, they get pasted in, and I can sign in. Great, that's the system working as you kind of sort of might expect. However, what if that didn't happen? What if I wasn't given options for this site? Well, let me refresh the page so that we're back in that case. And I'm going to click on my 1Password icon and click on essentially the corresponding entry for the site I expect. For example, this entry here is the entry where my askleo credentials are being stored. I'll click on that. And now you can see that I have the username, in this case, an email address of mine, and the password. But notice as I hover over each of those, it says copy. So I'm going to remember the email address because that's something that I can hold in my brain for the 10 seconds. But password, of course, is going to be something long and complicated because that's what I do. So I'm going to hit copy. What's happened is that password has now been copied into the clipboard. Now I can go back over here to the login field, right click on it, and click in paste. The password has been entered for me. And now if I enter in my email address, I can log in. In this case, I have two-factor authentication turned on, so in reality, I'm not going to log in. But you get the idea. Password managers can be used in a couple of different ways. One is to rely on autofill, but the other is to simply use them as a database of information that you can copy and paste to wherever you need it. In 1Password's case, that can be the browser extension, which you see here, or it can be a downloaded app that actually runs in Windows. I have an example of that in the companion article that goes with this video. But the bottom line is that that basically does exactly the same thing, except it saves it as a separate app that makes copy pasting just a little bit easier. But the bottom line here is that just that, you can copy and paste out of your password manager if it doesn't actually recognize the site and autofill for you. But make sure to double check that you're actually on the site you think you are before you do that. Hope that was helpful. Hope that gets you on to the next step. Like I said, this is important. Password managers, I believe, still are better than any other alternative, even if you need to do it via copy-paste. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/145981. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.